We're gonna go live. One. All right, we should be here.
Live?
And yeah, we are live.
All right.
Hello, everyone.
All right, so should I give you guys a 3, 2, 1?
That sounds good.
Yeah, it's good to me.
All right, cool. All right, 3, 2. All right, you guys are ready, right?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yeah, okay. 3, 2, 1, go. Cool, good luck.
Thank you.
So, do you want me to just go on a blitz of explaining things?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay, so Mirror's Edge is a fun game where you can get, you normally take a little while to get to full speed. We do this thing called the side jump boost where we flick our mouse to the left or right and you see our hands fly across the screen. That just gets us to full speed instantly. Up here, you're going to see we're probably neck and neck because this game is easy so far. You're going to see double kick glitches. Basically, there's a one-frame window when you do a wall run kick, and you can bind your scroll wheel to a jump button, and you can jump off the end of the kick animation. Let's get real far. You can also use that bound scroll wheel to jump quickly off walls. You jump on the wall, then quickly jump off of it. That's called wall boosting, and wall boosting is also really fast. If you understand those three things, you can kind of comprehend what's going on. We're pretty much just doing a lot of cuts and shortcuts to get through the level quickly. Also worth noting, you can chain wall boosts and kick glitches to get a lot of speed, so we do that whenever possible. Oh my god.
Yeah, you can chain, like, pretty much every movement technique in this game together, which makes for a very interesting movement set and very fun speed game.
Yeah, I wasn't supposed to fall there and die, believe it or not. So, I failed Gloss Shrouds.
Oh.
So I'm just gonna go back and, try that again. That puts me a couple seconds behind, but I think Mirror's Edge is known for having really, if you've played it as a speedrun or as a casual game, it can be kind of unforgiving sometimes, so. Although one person may be far ahead, and he might be far ahead the whole run, to be honest, but although he might be far ahead now, one mistake could put us right back neck and neck, so a lot of variability in the runs. Worth noting, I slowed down there because that helicopter is on a timer. If I go too quickly, I won't hit the helicopter trigger.
So, right there you saw me slide into both of these elevator buttons, and, you know, the elevator animations didn't trigger. And that's called a slide glitch. So what you do is, you have one of your mouse wheel directions bound to the use key, and if you do any kind of animation into an elevator button and you scroll, it'll skip the animation.
Also cool here, I think Fo probably did it too. I went for a double wall boost, didn't get it. But yeah, you're gonna see the slide glitch again up here on my screen. Real cool stuff. I don't know if it's clear in the layout. I'm on the right, he's on the left. I don't know.
So that's, I think, kind of the... Oh, I died on chapter one skip. So that's like the first instance of out of bounds we kind of use in this run.
Yeah.
It involves hitting a loading trigger and coming back into a previous area, and then it deloads, so you can skip a fair chunk.
Pretty cool stuff. I'm gonna try to also try chapter one skip. Pretty standard. I got it. Yay. There's actually an out-of-bounds skip on every level. We'll probably point it out when we get there if it's not completely obvious, but... Yeah, a lot of out of bounds. Especially in this game, a lot of running into checkpoint triggers that are later in the level, and then quitting and reloading. Oh, we'll show that off when we get there. But yeah, just a lot of wall boosting, kick glitches. I'm gonna try to do a kick glitch and then into a wall boost here to stack my speed. You pretty much just keep infinitely gaining speed until you hit the ground again. So we try to abuse kick glitches and wall boosts as much as possible and chain them off. If you don't hear us talking a lot too, very high concentration game, so we'll do our best. keep things informative, but also a lot going on. Normally you're supposed to go around these guards. I'm just going to go over them and then do an elevator clip. When the elevator starts going up, if I'm in the corner, I didn't get it. If I'm in the corner, you clip to the ceiling. Did you get it? Clip?
No, I missed it.
Okay. Well, there's a clip we'll both definitely get at the end of, or near the end of chapter two. So.
This one's more of a difficult clip because you have to time it. The other ones, you don't have to time as precise.
That clip's actually fairly new. It's probably, I think it's the newest clip.
Yeah.
That elevator in particular. Also, another cool thing you saw Zeus there, the kick glitch has a really cool property where the longer you wall run on a wall before you kick, the more height you'll lose. So if I wall run on a wall a really long time and then I kick, I can actually use that little platform I was talking about as a way to reset my fall height. Double wall boost here, really cool. You'll see another double wall boost later. You can use the wall run kick to reset your fall height. Conversely, if I want to get really far distances, I instantly kick the moment I start wall running, just so I can maximize my height, lose the least height possible. You feel. I'm nearing the end of chapter one.
Yeah, I'm messed up the chain, so. I didn't die. I had to do a really slow recovery.
What chain?
My chain.
Yeah, the Vo chain. I feel. I'm going for that in runs, but I don't think it's marathon safe yet. For me, at least. I feel though. So I think we're both going for a canal skip, right?
Yep, that's right.
Cool. I feel pretty confident. This is like the only big skip I feel confident in right now, so you can get excited. This is considered, I think Mirror's Edge has three or four, I'll say four, extremely hard skips that serve as a barrier between getting a really good time. Canal skip is the first one we'll see in the run. I think it's the easiest of the big skips, maybe tied with there's a skip near the end of the run, but I'm gonna try to get four kickflips in a row. I'm gonna use reaction time because it makes the timing a lot easier. And yeah. I didn't get it. I knew game.
Oh no, are you kidding?
No, I'm not. Okay. How do I wanna continue? So, Mirror's Edge has, if you mash enter after you miss a big skip, you go to a new game screen. And I shouldn't have mashed entered. I should have been more careful on my menus, but it's kind of instinct usually. When I was practicing earlier, that did not make me reset. So I just kind of went with that old muscle memory. So theoretically, I'd have to start over now. Kind of lame, but. So, you know, this is a very interesting part of the run, so I'm sure you're all very excited to see it again. That's pretty much the worst possible thing that any runner could do ever. Anyone who's ever speedrun this game right now is at home laughing. But on the bright side, I'm actually having a much better prologue than I did the first time around. So that's pretty exciting. Doesn't really compensate for the 7.5 minutes I just lost, but that's okay. You know, you win some, you lose some. The problem with continuing the run through a chapter select menus, which you could do, I could theoretically do, I could go into chapter select and, you know, keep going from there. The real problem with that is that, again, I mentioned it earlier, there's a lot of skips that require quitting and reloading. And those quit and reload skips can't be done unless you're in the process of starting from a new game and such. So it would just be kind of dumb for me to try to do those skips because I would just have to like simulate doing them. That's just silly. So we're gonna keep going. So how you doing, Vo?
Actually
doing new and interesting things.
I am currently doing the Storm Drain's exit climb. Yeah. This skips most of the climb. You just have to jump on a rail and get a really, really quick wall run. So you can stand on rails in this game, but only for a short amount of time. So you kind of fall off of it afterwards, like this. Oh, and I accidentally died while showing that off. That's okay. But yeah, you have to jump on these rails quite quickly, and then turn your camera in to get a wall run, which is not that hard, but you don't have a big window to do it. And you can just wall climb up these things, and that skips most of this section.
Yeah. Did you hit the button?
I did.
So once you hit that button, you kind of have to play the waiting game where you wait for the what's it called? The little stack of girders to get up to you. There's no way to speed that up, sadly.
All right, that was an elevator clip. That's pretty cool. That's what I missed in chapter one. So you can see Jackknife here is just kind of standing at a T position. So when you do the elevator clip in this section of the game, it doesn't actually trigger Jackknife to start moving. So he just kind of stands still and then a ghost runs in front of you. If you listen closely, you can hear him jumping fences and running around.
Yep. Well, gives me a second opportunity at this clip right here. So, that's fun, huh? I got it the second time, so this is what was supposed to happen. And then I tab to load level 1. You all run on the wall too long, you fall off of it, and then you can't kick or anything, so you just die. That's what you saw there.
So this is a nice skip here. There's a small part of this wall. You can do a wall run, kick off, and do a kick glitch, and it skips doing this whole section over there. And you can just run to the end of the level. Trigger it from the out-of-bounds space. Alright, so coming up is the next big trick. We call this the Tasseled Wobbegong, which is the name of the community's favorite shark. So we're gonna do a very precise climb here. It gets us all the way up here, and then we're gonna do a very precise kick glitch chain into a checkpoint. You have to get really good kicks and really good wall boosts here to get this chain. Let's see if I got it. I got it.
Oh, wow. Amazing.
So that saves about 40 seconds.
Yeah, that's one of the bigger skips.
It's fairly new as well.
Big skips. Yeah. I think we've always kind of known about it. It's just we used to think there was a much more precise way to do it, that now it's the only way to do it. But we now kind of have an alternative. So it's more consistent and actually doable in single side moves. It's neato. So again, I'm gonna do canal skip, except this time I'm actually probably gonna do it. So that's a little bit better.
All Alright, and in this next checkpoint, there is also there comes up the third hard trick of the game, called Crane's Kick Glitch. And this involves... I'm gonna go for it. Yeah. So this involves it's pixel perfect, frame perfect trick. It is extremely hard. So you have to get a kick glitch off of a very tiny lip in the ground. So if you kick glitch on that frame, it'll give you what's called a speedy kick glitch, which increases your speed so much that you can make it over bigger gaps.
Yes.
And
I can't, I don't want to like underemphasize how precise a speedy kick glitch is. Even if you get the speedy kick glitch too, you still don't necessarily get skip. I'm awful at getting them, and I have, you know, quite a few hours on this game, so it's a very difficult trick. Only a handful of people can do it semi-consistently.
I think I'm gonna go for it maybe 6 times before I give up.
It's a sizable time save of, I want to say 20 seconds maybe, but you probably know better, huh?
Yeah, I'd say about 20 seconds.
So not as critical as the tasseled wobble going skip, but I think that's been a lot of runners, when they come back to do any percent, choose not to do cranes and now instead do the new skip because it saves more time and is arguably easier. So you see that a lot now in the community.
One more try before I do the backup strats. Alright, I didn't get the speedy, unfortunately. So, I'm just gonna go for backup strats. It is a very hard skip. So, I'm not surprised I didn't fail it. I mean, I didn't make it. Oh.
I don't know if anyone's ever done it in any marathon so far, let alone gone for it, so it's just very precise. It kills a lot of runs. If you're going for any sort of world record. Just another elevator clip, and then walking into the loading zone. On my screen. Pretty sure Bo should be wrapping up chapter 3 right about now.
And if you do a jump off the ground and then do a Q turn, you can click the attack button and you can flip people off. Which is pretty nice.
Another cool thing you notice, he jumped up the crane arm. It's faster to jump up slopes than it is to just run up them. In general, it's faster to jump than it is to run. You jump at 29 or 30 kilometers per hour, while you run at around 25 or 26.
So I'm gonna fall into a loading zone here. I have to pause because this does take a bit to load. That skips quite a bit of the level. You get to save rope burn as well. If you play this casually and you don't know the speedrun, you only have to kill rope burn. But
it's ironic, the chapter itself is called rope burn, and you skip them entirely. You'll see that same thing happen later. So you went for 2 trains, I'm assuming?
Well, let's see. I got the first train. Missed the second train.
Trains are on a cycle, so you can usually skip that first train with the series of wall boosts you might have seen on that blue wall. That's we call that blue wall for reasons you can probably understand. Then you skip the second train just by having good bunny hopping and good train RNG.
And
sometimes the train tickles.
Yeah. Got 2 trains, so that's what it looks like.
Depends on your PC, I think, or your game, but certain people feel like get the better train cycle more often. But if you're fast, you can pretty much get it every time. You can get it every time. That's been confirmed. I again, during this, hopefully C3 to 3C skip again. I'm not as good as Bo at it, but I'll try.
So we have the classic auto-scroller that has to be in every good game. We just have to sit on these trains for a while and avoid these, but that's not too important. Just kind of dig around.
That should work. Yeah, I got the skip. Which would be, you know, pretty significant if I wasn't 7.5 minutes behind, so. Still pretty nice, though. This run, standing alone, you know, like, if you had time to reset, actually isn't half bad, but, you know, yeah. It's gonna keep going, it's gonna be great.
If we just move off to the right side of the train, we can get caught on the sign, and the train doesn't bring us all the way to the back.
And that yeah, there's no sort of the death animation associated with ramming into a wall too fast, so yeah. It works out. The interesting thing about that train ride, too, is the first part of the train ride involves the train actually moving forward, and then the entire middle, the beginning and the end are both like that, where you're actually on a moving train. The entire middle of the train ride is just an illusion, where the walls are moving really fast, and you're actually standing still. Theoretically, it would be faster to run down the train tunnel if we could somehow deload the train, but not possible. Found Mirror's fact of the day for you.
Alright, so I just did a kick glitch onto an invisible wall here. That you can stand on, which is pretty nice time save.
This is the route 90% of runners go through when they're not doing Crane's Kick Glitch, because Crane's Kick Glitch is dumb. So, this is much more typical.
This room, you see I lost a little bit of speed there, but you purposely have to go slow. Because for some reason, if you go through that room too fast, the next elevator won't load. And we're gonna do another elevator clip here. Very nice. We can get on top of this box before it loads, and that saves a little bit of time.
In case you didn't understand Chapter 4 skip the first time you saw it, you can see it again. Ta-da.
So that was a neat little trick in the elevator shaft to skip the pipes. It involves a series of wall runs and wall climbs. I find it really cool.
Cool thing about Chapter 4 skip in particular is there's been a lot of variations over the years of the best way to do that skip. I think there's probably, depending on how you classify it, 3 or 4 different ways to do skip in that area. And some of them go to different checkpoints, and some of them are significantly slower. Some of them can be done in chapter runs, the one we currently do right now. And some of them can't. So, just a really interesting history in that location. I'm gonna try to get good bunny hops here and again skip the train, but I'm not optimistic. Yeah, barely made it. Which is pretty cool. I fell. I'm trying to get back up, but it's not working. I'm just gonna go and hit the button again.
Alright, chat, can you please place your beamer bets.
Ooh.
I think I'm gonna
Where
get
you at?
Second try beamer.
So I've got this tremendous auto scroller part. Again, I'm gonna chill on the train. These are called chill strats, and not for the reason you think. Hopefully, I don't die.
All right, third try. So whoever answered third try, you have my undying laugh. And my game crashed. That's interesting. So, Chapter 5 fan. That's interesting. I've never seen that before. So that's gonna lose me a fair chunk of time. And you will get to see Beamer again. Unfortunately, most crashes are random in this game. You can't really control how they work. So.
Yeah. This game, it's normally not really horrible on the crashes, but it's definitely has an above average amount. Just a lot of trouble with loading and deloading levels. Did you explain Beamer? I don't think
I didn't explain Beamer, actually. Should have done that for it. You can explain it.
No, I got you, because I'm already a couple minutes behind. I don't mind. Beamer is this really cool thing where you get the salivary cliff.
Also, I think, did I get it first try just then? I wasn't watching.
Neither was I. So the thing about Beamer is that there are certain actions, such as clicking Q and turning yourself around, or doing a wall climb sidestep, that you can do from a wall climb. If you do one of those actions, right as, I guess I should say, if you do a wall climb and there's kind of like a little something jutting out of the wall, normally you just kind of like, I'm going to do a double kick glitch here, by the way, so that's going to be cool. Yeah. Normally, if you just try to wall climb, it just kind of like lets you wall climb up it. But if you do one of those actions I was talking about, in this case, he does a Q turn, on the exact frame that you hit the jut out, you get thrown away from the wall at very high speeds. And that's how we abuse that to get a speed bolt on a couch, thus skipping a large chunk of the level. There's also a really different skip in that same section. Gets to the same place, where if you do a certain animation on a certain sign, it randomly clips you through the ceiling. Doesn't make any sense. We don't really understand it, but that was the old method of getting a skip in that area. Luckily, we've moved past that, because that was a lot more difficult, many would argue, including myself.
Alright, so we're gonna do the chapter 6 out of bounds skip, sorry. So you saw me jump off that railing and then roll off of that invisible wall, and that just stops you from dying. Because if you just jump off, you die, but if you roll, the same platform that a kick glitch gets you is created.
Yep.
So it cancels fall damage. And then I went to a certain area and I hit a loading trigger, and then I kick glitched into the factory and it loaded around me. There I hit a button through a wall.
One of the skips that doesn't require you to it's like chapter 4, but you don't have to quit out and reload, it just kind of loads in, which is really nice. It looks better R2A, and we can do that, I think.
So that was super loud. So that button, you can actually hit that button multiple times, and since we use the slide glitch, we can hit it through the wall, and we can scroll our mouse wheel really fast. There it is again. And that hits the button a bunch of times, and it makes these things trigger faster.
Yeah, it's a really weird thing. You see it earlier in the run. We both skipped it, because we got the tasseled wobble gong 3C skip. But there's another elevator where if you spam the interact key, it also makes the elevator doors open faster.
And it makes loud noises.
That's pretty good.
That is good.
hopefully I don't get a crash. To get a really fast slide into the vent. I got it. Very common sense, sliding into vents always preferable to that slow crouch walk thing. So whenever we can do that, we try to really speed our way through vents.
So this may look like nothing. Oh, I died. So I was meant to hit a springboard there.
Oh, that's a tough one. Yeah, there's a hidden. There's pre-placed springboards in the world that like really magnet you to them. And those are usually, you know, a small thing, a small little box, and then two boxes stacked on top of each other. So you kind of, it's, you know, really nicely lined up for a springboard. But there are certain, even though there's no magnet, there are certain other environmental places where you can get a hidden springboard, we call them. They're unintended springboards. And then with those springboards, you can skip parts usually. There's another one in storm drains we both did, but didn't point out.
Alright, there we go. Third try. God dang.
It's really finicky. Little skip that isn't very popular because it wastes a lot of time but doesn't save too much. But it's really swag. Looks really cool if you do it right. Especially because you might get the nice double wall boost afterwards. I am also going to be doing factory skip.
Alright, coming up is the boat level. So, the boat level, titled The Boat. We skipped the boat, which is nice. Haha.
Yeah. Good joke. yeah.
So, basically, this level starts outside of the boat and it finishes outside of the boat. And the ending checkpoint still exists. It exists at all times, and we can just get out of bounds and run straight to it.
I've never died there before, that's cool.
We quit out and continue, and we're at the end, at the Celeste fight. Oh.
I didn't get it. Oh my gosh, stop.
I shouldn't have said Celeste, you don't know it's Celeste, that was a spoiler.
Yeah, spoiler alert for a game that's like 9 years old or something. I don't know how old it is, actually. Less than that, though. Eight years old?
I don't know. I don't know when it came out.
Yeah. Anywho. I'm trying to think of anything interesting I can talk about. It really isn't right now. I'm trying to get through this part. Normally you go up and around, but I'm just going to do a nice wall climb turn jump. And skip it. You've seen this before. I know it's not as interesting as what Foe's doing, but what are you gonna do? You just did Celeste fight, I'm guessing?
Yeah, just finished.
Person fight?
Just finished 8A.
Okay.
So, chapter 8's pretty chill chapter at the start. Gets to Atrium, which is a pretty fun area. It's probably my favorite area.
Yeah, very tech heavy, yeah. I think. Just because there's not a lot of big open spaces for you to run. So a lot of places for you to mess up if you're not careful.
There was a trick that skips the entire atrium called an infinite wall climb. I'm gonna try that once.
Oh my god, you monster. It's a tough one, but it performed well. It's actually kind of boring but really cool looking at the same time.
Yeah, since the atrium is such a cool area, but it skips it, but it's fun to do.
Really satisfying, just it's very mechanic, the infinite wall climb button inputs.
So we skip an elevator here by going out of bounds and then jumping into the checkpoint.
Did you do the good jump?
Yeah. Alright, infinite wall.
That's kind of risky.
Let's go.
So, an infinite wall climb, you can probably tell, a series of wall climbs, right. Side jumps, and then quick turns. And then from there you do a on the quick turn, you do a walk on turn jump. And then, yeah. You continue. I'm trying to get over the fence. It's not really working though. This is silly. I'm going to try one more time, and then I'm going to do a different method. Yeah, okay.
Alright. And you have to do this three times to get the top, because there's these little platform things here.
You're doing old school infant walk line?
Yeah, unfortunately I messed it up. I find it much easier than the new one, actually.
Cool thing about Celeste is that we kind of have her pretty down pat. I mean, this guard, who's not Celeste, it's five hits and then you just mash the disarm button. So very routine. The only problem with that is that she can roll away. He, she, whatever gender that unknown person is, not spoiler, can run away or roll away, and that'll skip a hit, but that only wastes like a second or two. Not cool though. You can usually skip her rolling away by pinning her against the edge of the crates.
So another chapter 8 out of bounds called Ventrium, because it skips the vent section.
Vents are slow and boring, so it's and for the best.
It's Ventrium because atrium and vent. So you just go out of bounds and you jump into the checkpoint, as always. Alright, this
and reload, and then boom.
Wall bang. Wall bang is pretty neat. So you have to kill yourself first, and that spawns a hitbox for the convoy you have to shoot. And what you can do is you can take the rifle into this corner, line yourself up, shoot here, and then it shoots the convoy through the wall.
Yep, for some reason that corner of the wall isn't loaded, just because of the way the collision works, so it's not really a wall bang, but like, it looks like one, you know. Weirdly made out of bounds texture.
There's a long section, we're just gonna skip this by doing a few rolls.
I'm just now entering the atrium, hopefully, if I jump into the trigger. Neato. I was careful with my menu there. I can't do infinite wall climb anywhere near consistently, so I'm not gonna go for it. But you go see there's this little mini infinite wall climb. Bo probably already did, but it's pretty cool.
Oh, all right. That's another instance of where we can free scroll something, skip an animation, and it also makes this fire come faster. Very loud.
Yeah, the free scroll mouse is good for getting a lot of inputs in a really short time, which is key to getting the sped up animations. I don't want to say it's impossible without free scroll, but free scroll is pretty much essential, unless you want to like turn your mouse over and roll it upside down or something.
And you'll notice I didn't do a slide glitch on that button, because sometimes if you actually scroll your mouse wheel too much, it'll get you stuck in the elevator. You can't move.
Very annoying. It can happen, it pretty much only happens in Chapter 1, which isn't a big deal, because it's so early in the run, and then that last elevator in Chapter 9, so...
Right, so I just... Yeah. Hit the elevator button from the outside of the elevator so the doors would open, so I can do the skip. We gotta do a very precise circle, and then some very precise pauses. This is probably my favorite skip.
Looks very good. Idiot, right?
Alright, got it. And you land in this out-of-bound zone, and you hit a checkpoint trigger. That's a cool skip.
And then sniper skip.
And then sniper skip. So instead of going around this area, if I can get this damn climb, which I can't seem to do.
Climb up on a lamp. The lamp lets you jump to out-of-bounds into this little convenient kind of alcove thing that's out-of-bounds. From that alcove, there's a very thin section of the wall that goes all the way across to the, from the beginning to the end. You can't run on it because it's too thin. Luckily, though, if you continue to jump, you somehow keep your balance. So, he's gonna do that.
I made it look really difficult, too, but it's quite easy.
Take me a little while to get there.
I'm standing by on time. I think you guys got, like...
There's like a minute left on mine.
Oh, there's a minute left on yours. Okay, cool.
And I'm assuming I'm way I don't know what our estimate was, but I'm not doing so hot. So if I don't make estimate, I can just cut the run off because I'm a little far behind.
Either or.
It was just really silly. But I don't know. This run as a standalone was fine, which is dumb because
it's just there was like a 5 or 6 minute.
Yeah, it's just a 5 or 6 minute reset. Oh well.
All right, nice little skip coming up here. Server room skip, or server room clip. Normally you'd have to shoot these servers and open the door up, but we can just clip through the wall here.
I think I probably got this. It's insane. I don't even get. Of course, I got. 3 of the 4 big skips in this run now with super extended dev, which is kind of dumb because I have struggled with getting all 3 of those even in my PB, so kind of dumb. Had to happen. I'm not timing this run. I wish I was.
All right.
Because this would actually be a decent time for me.
And time. It's end of time.
RTA 4055, I think.
4055. That's pretty trash.
Did you have your endgame going?
I did not.
No, 4050, excuse me. 4050.
I imagine
my endgame reset. I don't know why.
Crash.
You got this. Depend on how many more minutes you are.
I'm a minute and a half out.
We can finish out your run this run.
Okay. Yeah, this was a good run for me. I mean, it was silly because it was a bad run because it all kind of counts continuously, but this standalone run is actually really phenomenal for my, because I got all the big skips. So silly. I'm surprised I caught up as much as I did.
Yeah, with Fo going for a bunch of frame perfect crap.
Yeah.
I didn't go for the Crane's kick glitch because I've gone it once ever, so I don't find it marathon consistent. But besides that.
Yeah, I don't.
Other skips are also
I don't really find it marathon consistent. I thought I'd try and show it off.
Yeah.
Some of the stuff I wanted to show worked.
Bad movement. Got stuck on stuff, but that's okay. Also, we couldn't reload here because it skips this entire big cutscene where the antagonist is all like, "I'm kidnapping your sister." So it just that's like a 2 minute time save right there. Luckily, they put the checkpoint before the actual thing. Okay, that would be time for me.
Cool. That looks like a 42:31 after reset, so.
Yeah, when you cut out
When you cut out the reset, it was like a 5 minutes? 5 or 6 minutes?
More than that, yeah, the 6 minutes. Without that, it was like a 37 real time, I guess, which is better.
Mm-hmm.
But, that's the way it goes.
Well, yeah, good stuff, guys.
Ooh. Yeah.
Anything you want to say to the homies?
This game's pretty good. Try it out if you haven't.
Yep. Really cool speed game to get into just because it has the built-in chapter run function where you can compare against, you know, a big online leaderboard. So you get into that, and then from there you get into single segment. Just a really cool transition I think a lot of runners take. A lot of fun for every length of speed game you're looking for.
Yeah, for sure. Well, yeah, thanks for coming on, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
See you around. And up next, we've got Psychonauts with Grim Donuts. Stick around.